I'm a first year teacher, and sorry, I'm upset because I had kind of a rough day, as I'm sure many of us who came here straight from school did. I don't know if I can stay teaching forever, and that makes me really sad, because this is not my first career. I came back to school to be a teacher, and I really love the students that I work with, and sorry. I thought I would have time to prepare a statement today, but I woke up early to work on grading, and then I got to school early because I host a club before school for LGBTQ students, which I love, but it's hard because they often don't feel loved by the adults in their lives, so my days start off a little rough sometimes with them. And then at planning, I had two different meetings. I heard that, yeah. And then at lunch, I had a student in my room. We were registering for high school classes today, and he had an anxiety attack about the transition to high school. And so I was sitting with him at lunch, so I didn't have time to plan statements. but I just think about how much was put on us. And I know a lot of other new teachers, some of them do not have other like career experiences like I have, where they've gotten training in ACEs or de-escalation. And they're struggling even more than I am, because we're not given any social emotional support, really. I was so proud when I heard that Nashville is a city that embraces restorative practice. That was something really important to me when I was looking for a job as a new teacher. But we don't do enough. A lot of the teachers I've talked to who have been teaching much longer than me are frustrated by the restorative practice because they feel like they're given no support to make it happen. They've never actually been trained to do it. There's nobody in the building that can help them. And so we're all kind of struggling through something that we believe in but don't know how to put in place and haven't been given support for. And then on top of that, we're going home and we're working more, or we have a second job. I don't have a second job. I'm really lucky that I don't, but I also don't have kids or a house, and I don't know that I could have those things. And that makes me sad. It makes me sad that I have to go home and order a whole bunch more pencils and journals on Amazon tonight, because I have students that have like run out of spaces in their journals and are coming to class and saying, I can't do any more work because my mom can't buy me another journal. Or I don't have anything to write with today. And that's just basic materials. I also don't have enough copies of textbooks. I never have technology access in my classroom. My projector doesn't always work, so I don't even have that. And so I just think of someone who is new to this, who went back to school to do this, and I want to tell other people, you should be a teacher. I want to tell my students, you should be a teacher, but how can I do that when I feel like I can't keep doing it? Thank you.
Thank you.